Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We are here at Richmond for 60 laps of racing in the Blue Ox 400, getting ready for race 32 of the season. And after seeing those heat races, I hope we have some good racing here today. I'm actually expecting maybe one or two caution flags during the race, since we did have a crash in each heat. So starting lineup, Zachary Rogers, John Linares in row one. You got Peter Sands, Philip Tringali, row two. Tony Vieira, Karen Vieira, row three, with Mike Kidney, Michael Parker, row four. Nico Tringali and Nathan Rogers in row five. So with that said, 60 laps of racing here at Richmond. This track could be a chase race next season. And if Seth, if you're watching this, this is race 32 of 50. But anyway, we're underway here. Ooh, Peter Sands already looking on the back bumper of Zachary Rogers. You know, Peter hasn't won since Canadian Tire all the way back in the beginning of the season. Zachary Rogers has only won once this season, which is kind of a bit of a shocker for him, as he has seven career victories, tied second most with a couple of other drivers, such as Benjamin Tilton and Steve Cavallo, as he looks to get his eighth career win. And could he do it here tonight? He had a chance, I think, a few races ago to do it. What track that was at? If I look at it, I think I'll figure it out. I forget what track it was, but he did have a shot at winning at another track. Anyway, he continues to lead the race. Tony Vieira up to second. Peter Sands third. Michael Kidney fourth. And Austin Alves in fifth. Austin has yet to win a race this season. And you got to remember, he's won eight career races, and he has not won yet this season. And he would love to make the chase, since he missed it last year. So he's having a good run here today. Speedways tend to be his undoing from the late. Good thing for him, there's only two of those remaining before the chase, so he has a better shot of maybe trying to get a victory to get in the chase. As right now, Zachary Rogers continues to lead. By the way, we have 24 different winners in the season so far. Two winners are not in the top 40 in points right now. So that means right now we have two drivers getting in without a win. And those two drivers are in the top 10 in points. And they are Steve Cavallo and Andrew Rich. Now, I believe they are in the show today. Yep, Andrew is running back here in 16th. He's having a tough day, it seems. And we can see Cavallo in the back a bit more now. Three wide is not a good idea here. And whoa, the 32 and the 6 make contact. And they're still three wide. I'm not liking the look of this, guys. Whoa, Cavallo and James Morton making some contact. Andrew Rich still up top, three wide. Oh, James Morton gets to the five, and oh, there they go. That's going to bring out a caution. Michael Parker with damage. Andrew Rich, Logan York, James Morton, Eric Carolla. Zachary Rogers leads Micah Kidney up to second. As the field slows up, first caution of the race here on lap number 9. As these guys, I think, are just trying to get by the pace car, but they can't. As the leaders will come down the pit road, we will take another look and see what brought out the first caution of the night. And this really all started a while ago, back when they started going three wide. And now you're going to see how this happens here. And they're all just going to scrunch up. It seems three wide doesn't really work here. And the six gets into the five. The five will get into Ace Rogers. And that's going to send them bouncing off into Michael Cavanaro, right back into the six. Nowhere for anybody to go there. You see, Eric Carolla had nothing he could do right there. And then Michael Parker. And then Logan York bounces off of Dylan Young, and that's where he gets his damage. And that is the cause of the caution. Nicholas Samudio seems to get a few hits in there. But with that said, we'll take you to the race restart. Getting ready to go back racing. We've got a couple of cars a lap down. Michael Parker, Brandon Mellon. New race leader, Adam Rogers. Austin Alf, second. Torrey Travis, third. Allison Rogers, fourth. Alan Cavanero, fifth. Zachary Rogers down to sixth with Micah Kidney, seventh. Tony Vieira, eighth. Chris Criano, ninth. And Peggy Bowling is tenth. As the green flag is back out. Now, how will these lap down cars affect the start here? Oh, wow. Three wide already, and Torrey Travis to the race lead. Oh, and they're three wide teammates here. They got to be careful. But Torrey Travis to the race lead. Incredible three wide pass entering turn one. Could be looking for her second win on the season. And we have a caution? We have another caution. And it looks like Eric Harala was involved again. And James Martin is still wrecking. Let's see what caused our second caution of the night. I don't know if you can really blame James on this one. He just slides up a bit, and the 51 of Samudio. First off, it looks like the 5 car has damage and he's slow. The 51's just going to really just barely clip him. Gets into Sam Rogers, and that sends the 5 car around into the wall. So Mudio's going to spin out, and then Eric Harala has nowhere to go yet again. Same goes to Carroll Morton, hits the back of the 23. Then something happened after. Oh, wow, something happened here with Samudio. Oh, Samudio gets into the back of the 25, and that sends him around. And then James Morton just spins out. That's interesting. Well, let's get you to the second race restart. Getting ready to go back racing. Michael Park, the only driver, a lap down now. Torrey Travis leads the race. Allison Rogers second. Austin Alves third. Alan Cavanero fourth. Adam Rogers fifth. Micah Kidney sixth. Peggy Bowling seventh. Karen Vieira eighth. Brenda Rogers ninth. And Peter Sands tenth. Zachary Rogers has fallen outside the top 10 to 11th. Can he maybe try to get back up? We'll have to find out. Only one car lap down this time. But Parker with a good start. Could that mean a new race leader again? Austin Alves to the bottom, trying to use his teammate to help him out. And Austin Alves is going to head to the race lead. Now he's going to pass Michael Parker. New race leader, Austin Alves. And look who's up front for once, Alan Cavanero. Alan's having a good night tonight so far. Torrey Travis trying to move back up to the front. Torrey Travis is definitely moving up the field here. Or moving closer to 16. So Torrey Travis apparently has a good car to beat here. She wants to win. Looking down low on the 16, James Morton is slow. Eric Corral appears to be a little off the pace, but not by much. Zachary Rogers has lost a lot of damage. Actually has some rear end damage as he's fallen to 25th now. Mike Mellon's got some hood damage. And that could just be from slowing up for the cautions. Peter Sands moving up to third. As Torrey Travis is looking underneath of the 16 for the race lead. Torrey Travis. Oh, I thought she was going to dive it in that time. And she's to the inside again, but I think she keeps getting loose. And that is preventing her from making the pass. Halfway through, we're going to take a quick break and be right back. Back here already. Torrey Travis continuing to try to peek under the 16 for the race lead. Now, these drivers took their pit stop already, so I don't think they're going to be coming back in. As Austin Alves and Torrey Travis catch up to James Morton, could catching him cause a caution? And now Austin has the 34 on the inside. Torrey Travis trying to make the pass. And the 16's going to get stuck behind James Morton. New race leader, Torrey Travis, back out front. Thought I saw the lights out for some reason. I don't know why. So Torrey Travis leads Austin Alves now. Micah Kidney up to third. Peter Sands fourth. Tony Vieira is fifth. Allison Rogers sixth. Karen Vieira seventh. Alan Cavanero eighth. Deanna Jones ninth. Brenda Rogers, last week's winner, is tenth. As the field goes by James Morton. And Alan Cavanero got loose, and he's going to lose a spot. Maybe a couple of spots. Now Tony Vieira passing Peter Sands for fourth.
So we look through the field. Oh, sorry.
Oh, we have some three wide now. That's a motto. Logan York and Parker. Oh, and there's trouble up ahead. James Morton causing another crash. Dylan Young's involved. James Morton smoking now. Dylan Young, Nicholas Samudio, Chris Carando. Oh, no. The leaders are catching up. They don't have anywhere to go. Tony Vieira's up the third now. As everybody's racing back to the line. Easy, Nate. Oh, the 8 car gets really loose. We have more trouble. That's Sam Rogers in the 52 around. Well, let's take a look and see what James Morton caused this time, but I think it's safe to say he's finally done. After that last one. So let's take a look at the replay. This is just another three wide incident. This time Michael Cavanero and Dylan Young on the inside. And the 81 gets loose into the 5, turning him down. The 81 just clips Dylan Young, and that sends the 5 hard into the wall. And same goes for Dylan Young. And then Cameron Gadu, Zachary Rogers gets hit in the side. Nowhere for them to go. Benjamin Dion had nowhere to go. He's going to punt the 2 car there. Then we see Carol Morton. They're stacking up. Carol Morton, Nicholas Mudio, Ace Rogers. Ace sliding into the 2. And then something else happened with the 52 up ahead. This was after the crash. And Dylan Young comes out of nowhere. And Sam came down. I don't know if he knew the two was coming that fast, and he just got rammed by Dylan Young. Well, guys, with that said, we're about two-thirds through the race. Let's get you to the race restart. Going back, racing you with 18 to go. Benjamin Dion, James Morton out of the race. Torrey Travis, your race leader. 17 car on the inside again, but Tony Vieira is going to dive it down on the 16. New race leader possibly here in the 59 car. Tony Vieira to the front. Whoa, that's a voice crack. And Tony's going to waste no time getting right down the pass to 17 of Parker. Micah Kidney up the second. Micah could be looking for his first one on the year. Austin Alves up the third. Peter Sands moving up the fourth. Tony has already won once this season, winning back at Charlotte. But Austin Alves now up to second. Austin does not want to lose. He does not want to, like, not get a win here. So Austin diving in hard. He wants that ninth career win, and he is coming. Austin wants to make the chase this season, and he knows he's going to have to win to have a shot at it. To be the 25th different winner would definitely make things interesting. What are you doing? Dog's being a little weirdo over here in my bed. Torrey Travis, though, moving back up towards the front, up the third now, passing Peter Sands. We know she's got probably the best car on the track, so what can she do to track down the 16 and the 59? So we see the rest of the top five. Alan Cavanero, 6th. John Lanier, 7th. Allison Rogers, Kate Rogers, Mike Mellon up to 10th now. Look at Mike Mellon with that hood damage racing up to the top 10. And somebody's down pit road. Who was that? That's Dylan Young. And apparently Dylan Young cannot fix his damage as Austin Alves is going to pass Tony Vieira for the race lead. 11 laps to go here in Richmond. And Dylan Young definitely has a damage problem. They do not want to fix it all the way. I don't know why the game does this. But Austin into the lead. Tony second. And Torrey Travis is definitely tracking these guys down. Micah Kidney is running well, but he does not have the car or maybe the skill to win. Here comes John Linares with a late race charge. He's up to 6th. We know John has won at Martinsville twice, so he is no stranger to winning at short tracks. He could be looking for his first win on the season. And here we go. This is what I was talking about. Torrey Travis to the inside of Tony Vieira, going to pass him for second place. 8 laps to go. Sorry, I'm texting. Seven laps to go. And Tony Vieira has not given up. And Dylan Young is coming out right there. That's going to send Micah Kidney high. As Peter Sands is passing John Linares back for 5th. Look at Mike Mellon up here. Whoa, that was close. Mike Mellon up to 7th. Nico Tringali in 10th. 6 to go. Tony Vieira putting the pressure on the 34 as Austin Alves continues to pull away. By the way, guys, we're heading to Chicago next week as my dog just fell off the bed like a moron. So next week, we'll be heading to Chicago for the MyAFibStory400.com 400. And Tony Vieira will not allow Torrey Travis to win here, and I think that's going to maybe seal it maybe for Austin. Tony Vieira will move back up to second place. 4 laps to go for Austin Alves. Austin's just going to keep extending this win record, guys. He currently holds it alone at 8, and now he is looking to make it 9. 3 laps to go. And they are not really catching up to him here. So we look at the top 10. And let's look where Zachary Rogers is, because we know he had a good race going until pit stops really messed him up. And he's going to finish outside the top 30 from the looks of it. 2 to go here at Richmond. Tony Vieira trying to catch up to Austin Allis, but is there enough time? White flag is out this time by here at Richmond. 1 lap to go in the Blue Ox 400. And we know how much second place can mean to a driver. Torrey Travis might be trying to take that spot away from Tony Vieira. But it doesn't look like it'll be enough. Coming off a turn 4, Austin Allis wins his 9th career win in the Mountain Dew Vultures Cup Series. He wins the Blue Ox 400 here at Richmond as he looks to make another chase appearance in his career. Tony Vieira, 2nd, Torrey Travis, 3rd, Peter Sands, 4th, Micah Kidney, 5th, then John Linares, Mike Millen, Alan Cavanero, Nico Tringali, and Allison Rogers will round out the top 10. Hope you guys enjoyed tonight's race at Richmond. We will see you guys next weekend at Chicagoland.